Hi there. If there are multiple IP cameras that you need to use for a long run, the fair solution is add the extender on each cable line. But technically, it will increase the value point. So is there any way that you can use a continuous running cable? The answer is yes. Today in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the PoE switch to connect multiple IP cameras in a long range. But before we jump to the video, I'd love it if you could help us with the YouTube algorithm by liking our video. It would mean a lot to us to keep making the video about simple networking right here on YouTube completely for free. So first thing first, why is the PoE extender is needed? As you all know, the network is only limited to 328 feet. After that, the data will start dropping. So the extender will repeat the data, so you can use it beyond 328 feet without breaking the protocol. Well, you notice that I didn't mention the power, just the data, because power cannot be repeated. Only the data can. So once the power loss is lost forever, because it's just energy. Well, now, let's talk about our switch. This is our long distance PoE switch, and it has chipset built in for each port. It supplies our PoE network up to 1600 feet, which is around 500 meters. And then you will need to use the PoE extender at the end of the cable line before your camera. Now the switch will supply a long-range PoE network, and your camera can just be a regular camera. But just to keep in mind, every switch comes with only two extenders. So if you have more cameras, you have to get additional extender for each camera. Now, let's move to the demonstration board and show you how to set up a one-channel long-range. So here we are at the demonstration board. This is our NVR, and this is the long-range PoE switch that I was just talking about. And at the end, we have the IP camera. And this is the cable. And since I can't find any network cable over 1,000 feet, so I need to use the cabler to join those two together to get over 1,600 feet. So now let me show you how to do this. First, we need to plug in the cable line into the switch. I'm going to put it in port number 2, and the switch is already connected to the NVR. And now I'm going to use the cabler to connect both cable line together, just like this. It's very easy, over 1600 feet. And now, do you still remember the extender? Why do we need to use this? Because we need the signal from the camera, send it back to the switch. By the way, this is actually waterproof, so you can put it outside under any weather. And let's look at it. We have the input and output port. Just to make sure, you put the cable line into the input port. And then the output, we're going to plug in with the camera, just like this. It's very easy. Now you can see the indicator is on. We are ready to go. Let's put it in here. And since this is a motorized zoom camera, so it will take a few seconds to find the best focus. I think we are almost ready. And if you have another camera, you just do the same setup all over again. It's very easy to use. So do you remember that we mentioned the power can never be repeated? So if you're using one of these big boys, the PTZ camera, or any other high power device, you may face a power loss problem. But no worries. I'll recommend you to watch another video about a 90 volt PoE injector to increase the power for the network system. Thank you for watching.